All right, next question. Let's go with the spell over here.
What?
Oh, sorry, Sherry, Kathy, someone.
Hi, great job as always. I'm thrilled with how things have turned out. I wanted to ask, I know a few years back, a lot of the events were organized around tracks. It doesn't appear we've done that in these last couple of years. I was wondering what your thoughts are on doing tracks or even shadow cruise tracks around things from like user-generated content or writing or various things like that to make it easier to organize for, well, I have no idea if it's easier, but to manage venue space and planning and things like that.
It was a deliberate choice to not have sharply defined tracks. On the one hand, yeah, it can make it clear where you need to go. The thing that we like about not having specific tracks is that it makes it more likely that people are going to explore a wide variety of things. If there's something that we know people really want to do a lot, like tabletop gaming, then we don't necessarily call it a track, but it's programmed in a way that it's easy to find. And anything that emerges that way, that there's a large demand for it, will facilitate it that way. But we never want to so sharply divide what we're doing that it becomes rigid.
Yeah, we don't want to have sort of three or four or five different sort of mini fiefdoms and individual sort of narrowed groups of people. It's fine that people have particular interests, but we don't want to start establishing sort of this is sort of five mini events within a thing. And speaking from a venue space perspective, while there are certain things like the digital workshop being perfect for crafting and having space for it, a lot of times, while it would be more convenient that this place is always the author room or this place is always for acoustic music, frankly, in planning this thing, most of what drives venue spaces, this space has room for XD people or X hundred people, and we'll have very different events requiring that audience capacity, and that's sort of the primary driver because, my headache through the year is trying to program things such that nobody ever has to be turned away from an event they want to get to. It's not always achievable, especially on a limited, we're not in a 80,000 square foot convention center.
Yet.
but that's always the thing we're trying to achieve. It's mostly just like, can we get, based on the expected demand for a thing, can we provide the appropriate space for it? So the tracks are still kind essentially there. We're just not labeling them.
They're fake tracks.
Yeah. And also SCED, one of the nice things about SCED is you can create a login and then just mark all the events that you have a particular interest in. And so it sort of establishes your own track for you. Like you can just click on all of the crafting or all of the tabletop gaming events so that you see where that track lies. So,
DIY tracks, that's what we have.